Honda's updated Civic sedan for 2019, including this, the sporty high-spec RS. Not to be outdone, Skoda has spruced up its Octavia here in fetching sport form. So, which of these $30,000 sport sedans is our pick? Forget the hatchback. The sedan is the looker of the Civic stable. Its edgy design, 18-inch wheels, and RS-exclusive Phoenix Orange paintwork makes it look quite handsome in a way its heroic Type R twin, well, isn't. You get this aggressive and angular design, LED headlights, lots of blacked out highlights, and up the back, a discreet boot spoiler. And I'd go as far as to say that this is the best looking Civic you can currently buy. In this trim, it wants for $31,990 in any colour other than this, which is an extra $575. Meanwhile, the Octavia Sport Auto lobs in at $31,490. But this fancy digital dash at $700 and the white paint, or very, very light grey paint, wants for a further $500. So only $175 splits these competitors. Looks-wise, it's an honest, hard-working, largely unremarkable kind of appearance in every way except for the gaudy quad headlight treatment. It's as if mediocre was the design brief for the Octavia, and that's really not that surprising. That's because Skoda is a cut-price sibling of Volkswagen, which is the mainstream relative of Audi, which is the premium badge cousin of Porsche, which isn't quite as exclusive as Lamborghini or Bentley. That said, it's almost charming in a refrigerator white, light grey, sort of way. And designers slipped in a little sexiness when Volkswagen wasn't looking, with the brushed alloy 18s and a lick of black paint here and there. But not everything is what it seems with these two sedans. For a start, the Civic is categorically a small sedan, but at almost 4.7 metres long, it's a pretty large small sedan at that. Meanwhile, the Octavia typically gets lumped in with a medium car set, despite the fact it's only 5 millimetres longer. The Skoda continues its deception when it comes to boot space because it doesn't actually have a boot lid at all. It's a liftback. And it's huge too, the Skoda's 568-litre capacity beating out the Honda by 51 litres. Given the Sport is a mid-spec Skoda, you'd expect a low-rent interior, right? Not necessarily. There's a strong whiff of Volkswagen in the wheel, switchgear and infotainment, but that's not a bad thing at all. The seats are mechanical with a sort of hardy fabric, but they're plenty comfortable. And you get a few of those simply clever Skoda treats, like flock door bins, to stop your bottles from rattling around. It's neat, grey and largely unremarkable in here. The touchscreen looks great, but it doesn't have sat-nav or digital radio. And don't get too excited about these alloy inlays either, because they're plastic. The conspicuous highlight is the digital virtual cockpit system. Yes, just like Audi calls it. But again, this extra special feature will pry an extra special $700 deeper into your hip pocket. Second row space is good. In fact, it's really bloody good. I'd go as far to say that most adults will find it roomier and comfier than any small SUV you could name. You get rear air vents and this newfangled phone holder that looks suspiciously like an old-fangled ashtray. It's just plain weird. Over in the Civic, you'd expect the RS to be fancy. And in general, particularly the styling and the seats, which are leather, have these red stitching and are heated, it's certainly fancier than the Skoda.
But it's not as upmarket as its rival. The smaller 7-inch infotainment and LCD instruments aren't as slick, and some of the materials look and feel pretty cheap.
Unlike the Skoda, get smartphone mirroring and digital radio, but still no sat-nav. Proof that more interesting doesn't necessarily mean better.
While the Civic gets a smaller boot, it trades off with a bit more legroom. Frankly, for a small car, the back row is enormous.
But that's really it for the positives in the back. There are no air vents, no USB ports, and no old-fangled ashtray to hold your phone.
So far, it's a battle of looks and vibe against substance, and they're quite evenly matched thus far. Let's hit the road. What really excites is under the hood, says the Honda website. And of the two sedans, the Honda is the bigger powerhouse.
The thing is, the Civic just makes 127 kilowatts and 220 newton meters of torque, and it's tied to a CVT transmission. If that sounds more like an SUV than a sports sedan powertrain, then you'd be right.
Except the similar 1.5 turbo fitted to the CR-V actually makes more power and torque than this sedan.
Oh dear. But what's really surprising is that on the street, it feels reasonably potent. Sprightly, in fact. Even better, it'll run on crappy 91 RON fuel and return a claim of 6.3 litres per 100. As for the rest of the experience, it does feel sportier than the Skoda. The dynamics are sound and the ride's pretty impressive as well.
Overall, it's a fine, accomplished and downright likeable car around town. But if you're expecting a warm sports sedan approximation of a Type R, then brace yourself for disappointment.
The Skoda gets a 110 TSI engine, and it's no great coincidence. That sounds a lot like a garden variety Volkswagen Golf motor. But while 110 kilowatts is fairly make do, the engine does produce fairly decent 250 newton meters. The only problem is, what's really letting the team down is a fairly clunky 7-speed dual clutch gearbox.
In short, it's a more refined and sophisticated powertrain than the one in the Honda. But it does need 95 RON fuel, and that 5.2 litre combined claim should be taken with a lump of salt.
That Volkswagen DNA extends down through to the underpinning, so you get a lot of those nice, sweet Golf dynamic traits.
It rides nicely, steers clearly, and is light and nimble on its feet. But despite its sports namesake, it doesn't quite have the sporty vibe like the Honda has.
So, where does that leave us? With two quite different, but equally well-regarded machines. Crucially, both offer a degree of sportiness, and the Skoda just doesn't really deliver much of it in the experience. The Civic, on the other hand, looks much sportier, drives quite a bit sportier, and is my pick for the $30,000 sporty sedan. Tell us what you think in the comments below, and don't forget to subscribe.